will rejoice in you and be glad. I will extol your love more than wine. Draw me up to you and let us run.
It's a choice I make. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
That's a choice I make.
Amen.
You can choose life, you can choose death. You can choose blessing or a curse. Mm. Moses, the man of God, said it in Deuteronomy chapter 30. He said, behold, I lay before you life and death, blessing and cursing. Mm. Choose blessing.
Amen.
Choose life.
Amen.
That you may live and your children after you.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
ாலும் சுகம் தரும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் எதிரியை தூரத்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் என்னாலும் சுகம் தரும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் அதிகாரம் தந்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் அதிகாரம் தந்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் அது செய்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நமக்கு அது பாவங்கள் போக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பரிசுத்தமாக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பாவங்கள் போக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பரிசுத்தமாக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் சாபங்கள் நீக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் சாபங்கள் நீக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் சமாதானம் தந்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நமக்கு சமாதானம் தந்திடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ஓ ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ஓ ரத்தம் ஜெயம் கல்வாரி இயேசுவின் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் காருண்ய தேவனின் ரத்தம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பலவீனம் நீக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பலவீனம் நீக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் பலவானாய் மாற்றிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நம்மை பலவான மாற்றிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ஓ ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் காருண்ய தேவனின் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நாமத்தாய் பரித்து பேசும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் கால்தோறும் பாதுகாக்கும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நாமத்தாய் பரித்து பேசும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் கால்தோறும் பாதுகாக்கும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நீதிமானாக்கிடும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நேர்த்திய ஜீவன் தரும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் நமக்கு நேர்த்திய ஜீவன் தரும் ரத்தம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ஓ ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் ஓ ரத்தம் ஜெயம் கல்வாரி இயேசுவின் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் காருண்ய தேவன் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் கல்வாரி ரத்தம் ஜெயம் காருண்ய தேவன் விடுதலை தருகின்ற ரத்தம் ஜெயம் வெற்றி மேல் வெற்றி தரும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம் விடுதலை தருகின்ற ரத்தம் ஜெயம் வெற்றி மேல் வெற்றி தரும் ரத்தம் ஜெயம்
Pray. Father, thank you for this opportunity you've given us again to worship you in spirit and in truth, to lift up your holy name in song and in worship. And even now, as we come before the throne of grace, we thank you because an opening has been made for us through the precious blood of Christ and the name of Christ. And even now, as we stand before you, we thank you because your name is holy. Oh, your name is righteous. Your name is all encompassing, oh Father. And we submit ourselves under that mighty name of the living God. We pray that your name will be glorified in our lives as we listen to the word that you have in store for us, the wisdom key for today. And we pray it will be a blessing to every one of us to not just be hearers of the word, but doers of the word as well. We thank you and we worship you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Today I'd like to share with you the 8th wisdom key, which I believe will be a blessing to us as we learn about it, as we read and study the scriptures again this morning. Have you ever faced struggle in your life? Or are you in the midst of a struggle that is going on in your life right now?
I want you to know that struggle is proof that you have not yet been conquered by what is trying to snuff out the best things of God in your life. So don't be living in a state of despair just because of struggle. Don't think that everything is over. Remember, nothing is over till God says over. And God has not spoken the word over over your life. So be of good cheer. Remember, the eighth key we are going to study is struggle is the proof that you have not yet been conquered. Now, as long as you have not yet been conquered, you are still capable of winning. You still have the attitude of a winner. That's why you are having something that is struggling to wrestle with you and trying to put you down. But if you have enough confidence in God, and if you are able to trust God enough, remember, every struggle is a proof that you are the winner, and the struggle will be as nothing before you. I want to read to you from one portion of scripture that is very amazing, which we have in the New Testament, from the life of no one else but the Apostle Paul. The Apostle Paul writes about the struggles he had to face. And when you read about it, you can take great encouragement, you can receive great inspiration, and you can be challenged to rise up above this struggle that is going on in your life or in this season of life, this very moment, and choose to latch on to what produced victory in the life of the Apostle Paul, which will be similar in your life as well. Remember, victory can only come from the victorious one, and there's no one more victorious than the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Now let me read to you, please, from 2 Corinthians chapter 6, and we are going to read verses 1 to 13. 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 1 to 13. For our understanding this morning, I want to read to you from the Message Bible of 2 Corinthians chapter 6 and verse 13. I'm using the Message Bible because it's much more lucid and in modern day language easy to understand, and I'd like to read it to you because it has a wealth of revelation in it. I'm reading from verse 1 onwards. Companions, as we are in this work with you, we beg you, please, don't squander one bit of this marvelous life God has given us. I want you to highlight this, please, in your Bible. Don't squander one bit of this marvelous life God has given us. Today, people are squandering the life that God has given them by either throwing it away and resigning themselves to fate, or some of them even attempt suicide, kill themselves, or some of them just don't do anything about what God gives into their hands. They're squandering the marvelous life that God has given us. Remember, as he begins this, he calls us workers together with him. I wanted to highlight that phrase. If you're following the King James Version, it's written workers together with him. In the Message Bible, it is companions. That means as you work alongside with God, there is victory. Every struggle will be as nothing before you. Verse 2, God reminds us, I heard your call in the nick of time. The day you needed me, I was there to help. Now that's God speaking to you and me. God is a God who hears us in the time accepted. What is the time accepted? It is a time when we choose to call upon God and Him alone. We don't use that time lightly by calling upon this person and that person and this person and that person. It's time you directed your call to God Himself. That's why it's necessary for every Christian believer to know how to pray. It's wrong for Christian believers to depend on the pastor to pray, for the evangelist to pray, for the apostle to pray, for the prophet to pray, and for the teacher to pray for them. Every Christian believer must know that God is fully accessible to them right where they are as they call upon Him in the name of Jesus. The password to enter into the presence of God is the name of Jesus. And so God wants every Christian believer to come to that place where they have a prayer life. Of course, the fivefold ministry is given for the edification of the church. It is not given as a substitute for personal prayer. Now, Bible says, I heard you in the nick of time, the day you needed me, I was there to help. What a wonderful, thrilling blessing it is to know that God was there when everything else failed. Well, now is the right time to listen, the day to be helped. God is the God of the now. That's why I made mention of it last week when I said, there's no book more current than the Bible. Don't ever think the Bible is redundant. The Bible is never redundant. The Bible is a current book. And God is the God of the now. He's not the God of the past. He's not just the God of the future. He's the God of the now. Well, now is the right time to listen, the day to be helped. Don't put it off. Don't frustrate God's work by showing up late, throwing a question mark over everything we are doing. Are you listening? Some people live their entire life wondering whether the pastor is wrong, whether the evangelist is wrong, whether the apostle is wrong, whether the prophet is wrong, whether the teacher is wrong. Don't waste your time putting a question mark over everything that we are doing. Our work as God's servants gets validated or not in the details. People are watching us as we stay at our post, alertly, unswervingly, in hard times, tough times, bad times. I like you to write them down if you don't have a Message Bible. I want you to write down these three type of times mentioned for us in the Message Bible. It says hard times, tough times, bad times. Just adjectives to describe how harsh sometimes things can be when the struggle is on. When we are beaten up, jailed and mobbed, working hard, working late, working without eating, with pure heart, clear head, steady hand. I wanted to make note of all these things. These are the qualities that make a man victorious in life, whether you're in ministry or in personal life. It says, in gentleness, holiness, and honest love. When we're telling the truth and when God's showing His power, when we are doing our best setting things right, when we are praised and when we are blamed, slandered and honored, true to our word, though distrusted, ignored by the world but recognized by God, terrifically alive though rumored to be dead, beaten within an inch of our lives but refusing to die, immersed in tears, yet always filled with deep joy. Verse 10. Living on handouts, yet enriching many. Having nothing, having it all. Dear Corinthians, I can't tell you how much I long for you to enter this wide, open, spacious life. Can you imagine how the mind of God is when it comes to the Christian believer? He is not wanting you to live a narrow life. He is asking you to enter into this wide, open and spacious life. How do you find that this life is not crushed into a small segment? When you walk with Christ, you are walking with Creator of the entire universe. We didn't fence you in. The smallness you feel comes from within you. Your lives aren't small, but you are living them in a small way. Are you listening? Life is not small, but you're living them in a small way. I am speaking as plainly as I can and with great affection. Open up your lives. Live openly and expansively. He didn't say live openly and expansively. He said live openly and expansively. That means expand. Don't let yourself be pushed into a small space. Live expansively. There's a lot of difference between living expansively and living expensively. Today people are thinking living expensively is what God is expecting from them. God is saying no, live expansively. That means cover as much space as you can for the kingdom of God. Make your presence known for the kingdom of God, not for any other purpose. That people see your life and understand that this man was going through this kind of a struggle. It's so terrible. Sometimes he's honored, sometimes he's blamed, sometimes he's living in great, abundance. It looks like sometimes he doesn't have anything, but his life is enriching many. Has your life been a source of enrichment to many? Check that out. As long as that is happening, remember, you are the winner, you are the victor over every struggle you face. Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't sit back and think, well, this life is too small for me. God has kept me in such a small place and I'm a nobody. No one is really a nobody as long as they remain in the kingdom of God. You're a somebody. You're a child of God. And God has anointed you and given you the anointing for a purpose. Draw inspiration from 2 Corinthians chapter 6 verses 1 to 13. I mean, you can read it in the King James Version of the Bible or whatever version you have, and it still will communicate the same meaning to you. It tells us that as long as you're a Christian believer, you're not going to be free from struggle. Struggle is the proof that you have not yet been conquered. I want to continue reading from another portion of scripture to you about this struggle that we face in many ways in our life, whether you're in ministry or whether you're in just a job that is making you interact with people in the world, you must understand that struggle is a part and parcel of your life, especially if you're a Christian believer. Now, I want to read from 2 Timothy chapter 4, verses 9 to 18, to just show you another part of the struggle that Paul faced. He had already spoken a lot about it from verses 1 to 13 in 2 Corinthians chapter 6. Now, I want to read to you from 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verses 9 to 18. I just want to read the scriptures to you. I want you to let the strength of the scriptures speak to your heart. You must understand that preaching and teaching are very peculiar in God's kingdom. There are special anointings given by God for both these type of ministrations. But there's also a ministration that comes when you let the word of God speak to it to you by itself without any additions and subtractions. You let the word minister to you. And when you let the word sink into your spirit, that produces phenomenal results in your life. So let's read from 2 Timothy chapter 4. And let me read to you from verses 9 onwards. I want you to see the struggle that Paul is facing while he is in Rome. And he's writing to Timothy his protege in the ministry, who he considered a son in the faith. Do thy diligence to come shortly unto me. For Demas hath forsaken me, having loved this present world, and is departed unto Thessalonica, Crescens to Galatia, Titus unto Dalmatia. He's talking about the ones who were close to him, all who have moved away. Only Luke is with me. Take Mark and bring him with you, for he is profitable to me for the ministry. And Tychicus have I sent to Ephesus. The cloak that I left at Troas with Carpus, when thou comest, bring with you, and the books, but especially the parchments. Alexander the coppersmith did me much evil. The Lord reward him according to his works. Of whom be thou aware also, for he had greatly withstood our words. I want you to mark that down, please. What is the struggle at times we are faced with when people withstand our words? Here is Paul with the revelation of God in his heart, speaking to people in the church, and there is this man who is Alexander the coppersmith, who has successfully evaded the words of Paul and resisted those words. Verse 16. At my first answer or hearing, as it is written in the Message Bible, the Amplified Bible, it will be written as at my first trial. No man stood with me, but all men forsook me. Can you imagine? You're going to be tried and you're looking around to see for some familiar face, and there's no one standing with you. Terrible to know that you have been forsaken. It's terrible for you to feel so lonely and alone. I pray God that it may not be laid to their charge. This is the mind of a victor. This is the mind of a winner. He is not blaming people and saying, you were not there, you were not there, you were not there. No. He is instead praying to God and saying, God, don't lay it on their charge. Don't hold it against them. Forgive them. This is the sign of a winner and a victor. Notwithstanding, the Lord stood with me and strengthened me, that by me the preaching might be fully known, and that all Gentiles might hear. And I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. I want you to mark that down, please. He says, God stood with me and strengthened me so that all the Gentiles in Rome could hear me. And I was delivered out of the mouth of the lion. He's talking about his death. He says, I didn't have that painful death come upon me where I was thrown and at the mercy of wild creatures. And the Lord shall deliver me from every evil work. Can I have an amen? The Bible says God will deliver you from every evil work and will preserve you, like he did Paul when he says, and will preserve me unto his heavenly kingdom, to whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I want you to join me as we say this amen again. Amen. That's the purpose of God, to deliver you from every evil work and to preserve you unto his heavenly kingdom. There's no greater joy in God's mind than to have you join him in his heavenly kingdom. He's not the one sending you to hell. He's not the one who's wishing you fall and backslide. He's not the one who's wanting you to run after wrong doctrines. Remember, Paul talks about these wrong doctrines in the previous chapter. He is not the one who's sending those men. He is not the one who's trying to tempt you to fall and go away and, you know, wander away from him. He is the one who is preserving you. He is a preserver. Hallelujah. And he is the one who is doing it with the heavenly kingdom in mind. To whom be glory forever and ever. Amen. I want to close with these words. And I want you to believe God that as long as struggle is evident in your life, it is proof that you have not yet been conquered. You are a winner. Have the mindset of a winner. Don't have the mindset of a defeated person. Don't keep blaming people all the time. Don't be looking for some scapegoat. Try to put the blame on someone. Be a man, be a believer in Christ, be a victor in Him, a winner, and learn to stand up and handle struggles, the right attitude, and to learn from men who have done it in the past. Depending on God, they did it. And today we remember them with such honor and love. Let's pray. Father, in Jesus' mighty name, we thank You because Your word is so powerful that it speaks for itself and it's fully capable of making changes in all our lives, O Father. We pray in the mighty name of Jesus that whoever may be going through a season of struggle will feel encouraged this moment to know that they have not yet been conquered. That every challenge is a scaffolding to greater heights. In the name of Jesus, that they have the mind of a winner as long as they have the mind of Christ in their hearts, O God. Have mercy upon them. Blood protect everyone, young and old. O precious Father, families and individuals, may they be blood protected in the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are looking to You for solutions to problems and to some peculiar condition in their life, we pray that the solution will come through. And they will know that You're a God who has heard them in the time accepted. Thank You, Father, for deliverance that is on its way right now towards Your people. It's coming towards Your people for Your glory and Your glory alone. May You preserve each one who is opening their hearts to You this very moment. O Lord, may they be preserved till the time they come to Your heavenly kingdom. In the mighty name of Jesus, for Your glory, we thank and we worship You. Blessed be Your name. Continue to be with Your children right through this third week of October. In everything they do, let them see victory. In the name of Jesus, let them see Your goodness in the land of the living. Every day be filled with joy and strength from on high. Thank You, Father. Blessed be Your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Everybody said, Amen and Amen. May the blessing of God the Father, the blessing of God the Son, and the blessing of God the Holy Spirit rest and abide with each one of us, both now and until Jesus comes again. ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் கிருபையும் பிதாவாகிய தேவனின் அன்பும் துய பரிசுத்த ஆவியானுடைய ஐக்கியமும் நம்மோடு கூட இன்றும் என்றும் இருப்பதாக. ஆமேன் அண்ட் ஆமேன். ஹாலெலூயா, ஹாலெலூயா. ஐ வாண்ட் டு ரீட் திஸ் வேர்ஸ் அகெயின் டு யூ அண்ட் லெட் தோஸ் வேர்ட்ஸ் மினிஸ்டர் டு யூ அஸ் வி க்ளோஸ். அண்ட் த லார்ட் ஷெல் டெலிவர் யூ ஃப்ரம் எவ்ரி ஈவில் ஒர்க் அண்ட் வில் ப்ரிசர்வ் யூ அன்டு ஹிஸ் ஹெவன்லி கிங்டம், டு ஹூம் பி க்ளோரி ஃபார் எவர் அண்ட் எவர். ஆமேன். பி ஆஃப் குட் சியர். God loves you. Turn your heart over to Jesus and remember, living for Him every day is a high privilege. God bless you.
Nanedu eka reethi gavum naadu sarva kalamandu jayamichunu.
Nanedu eka reethi gavum naadu sarva kalamandu jayamichunu.
Halleluya. சந்தோஷமே, சமாதானமே, ஹல்லேலூயா. ஆனந்தமே, சந்தோஷமே, சமாதானமே. பிரேமிச்சு தேவன், ரட்சிச்சு தேவன், பாலிச்சு தேவன், இயேசு தேவன். பாட்டு பாடி
make sure you don't miss receiving our free monthly newsletter, The Pulpit, which contains a four-part teaching series on various Bible topics that will help you live in victory. You can read it online by going to christchapel.in and click on ebook library, where you will find all our newsletters available. To receive a physical copy of Pulpit, you can go to christchapel.in and click on Join Now and fill in your complete postal mailing address along with your contact mobile number, and we will be happy to send it to you free and postpaid. Should you want to receive the newsletter via email, do include your request along with your current email ID. Thank you and God bless.